You do seriously surprise me.
Thank you, Chef. I was hoping you'd see that. I mean, I'd give it all I got. Give you 110.
You surprise me to how shit you are.
Netflix has had their fair share of anime and have even become a contender in the anime streaming business. They've had some great anime in the past, and they've also had some not so great anime. Netflix has just released their new anime, Record of Ragnarok, which is a manga that I've been quite excited to see get an anime adaptation. Similarly to Baki, it is focused primarily on its fighting. Record of Ragnarok has been out for a week now, and people are not really happy with this one. Today, I'm going to go over my thoughts on Record of Ragnarok anime and why I personally did not enjoy it. But before we start, make sure to subscribe to the channel for more content like this and slap that like button until it can't be slapped anymore and it becomes as still as every fight in this anime. I'm going to start off the video with the things I did enjoy, which really isn't much, and then I'll get to the bad stuff. I found the soundtrack to be actually pretty good. The more orchestral vibes it had really fit the series. Spoiler warning, so skip ahead to the timestamp on the screen if you don't want to be spoiled. Anyways, when Adam died, the soundtrack was amazing. It was like somber, but like beautiful. The soundtrack single-handedly made the scene for me and overall made a lot of scenes better than they would have been without it. I definitely recommend you give the soundtrack a listen. Although I didn't really like Adam versus Zeus, which I will explain later. I actually thought Adam's backstory was pretty well adapted. I had no issues with it. The voice acting was great. The characters were all portrayed very well, and the characters sounded how I expected them to sound when I originally read the manga. Although the overuse of still frames is annoying and problematic, most of the time they do a pretty good job of reenacting the panels from the manga, with exceptional details. Since we're talking about the good things, I want to mention Kojiro vs. Poseidon, because it was surprisingly not bad and honestly pretty solid. I think Kojiro's backstory was well done, and the still frames kind of worked with this one pretty well considering the fact that the fight is at a slower pace compared to the other two. Pacing was fine for this fight. This fight could have definitely been done a lot better, but it was overall pretty enjoyable. Alright, that's all the good things, so now we get to the bad things.
I loved you!
I'm gonna start off by talking about the elephant in the room, still frames, because wow, there were a lot. Now I get that this studio isn't known for its work on fight sequences, but the still frames just came off as obnoxious after a while. This whole studio problem reminded me of One Punch Man Season 2, which was done by a studio who was known for making slice of life anime. Although it wasn't great, at least it was decent and had some form of animation. There are a lot of moments with certain characters like Brunhild where the expression is changed to a more basic anime expression, which I'm not a huge fan of. I personally really enjoyed the wacky expressions the manga had. Also, why did Thor not smile in that one part of the fight? Why did they change that? Which brings me to my next problem. Thor versus Lubu. I'm just gonna start off by saying, this fight was dreadful. Thor's backstory was terrible. The animation was laughable. It was literally still frames for like half the episode. What happened to that one scene where Thor smashed that incubus guy with his hammer and saved Brunhild? Did they not animate it because it was too violent or inappropriate? I felt like that scene was pretty important for Thor's character, and it was also how he was introduced in the manga. The pacing in this fight was awful. I felt like it was never gonna end. I found myself losing focus and just overall interest in these episodes. The crazy part is that I loved reading this fight in the manga. This was super disappointing. Lubu's backstory was okay. It wasn't amazing, but it wasn't terrible either. I feel more indifferent about that one. Overall, this fight felt like I was looking for a new wallpaper on Wallpaper Engine. Alright, let's talk about the big one. Adam versus Zeus. Now, this one was immensely disappointing. This was my favorite fight in the manga, and they gave it the Way of the House Husband treatment. Apparently, House Husband's animation was supposed to be an artistic choice, but Adam versus Zeus has no excuses. This fight was actually a PowerPoint. And I thought Mirio vs. Overhaul from My Hero was a PowerPoint until I saw this. It was mostly similar to Thor vs. Lubu and how it felt like Wallpaper Engine. But then the biggest part of the fight, the climax of the fight, ended up being a 16-second slideshow of highly detailed images. When I first saw this scene on Twitter, I honestly didn't even believe it was real. I thought it was an edit or like a meme or something. The whole fight was basically just the same loop of Adam punching and Zeus weaving Adam's punches. The pacing wasn't great either, but are we really surprised after Thor versus Lubu? They showed a glimpse of Jack the Ripper versus Hercules, and it looked good for the minute it was on screen, but is it really gonna end up being a solid fight? Will they change studios? Will another studio remake the entire anime as a whole? Jack the Ripper versus Hercules was great in the manga, but with what just came out on Netflix this past week, I'm not even sure if I'll tune in to find out. When your anime is primarily focused on its fights, and they aren't pleasing to look at, That really hurts his overall reputation and entertainment value. I'm not sure if I should call this an animation or an animatic. If you have interest in the series and want to see these fights done extremely well with fantastic art, I'd recommend you to just read the manga. And with that, I'm gonna have to give Record of Ragnarok 5 highly detailed still frames out of 10.